السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي فضل سيدنا ومولانا محمدا على العالمين جميعا وقامه يوم القيامة للمذنبين المتلبسين الخطائين الهالكين الشفيعا فصلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى كل من هو محبوب ومرضي لديه صلاة تبقى وتدوم بدوام الملك الحي القيوم أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير صدق الله مولانا العظيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما تقرب سائر الشريف اللهم صل على سيدنا مولانا محمد وبارك وسلم صلوا عليه صلاة وسلام عليك يا رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم Respected brothers and sisters, this afternoon I'm going to speak about Al-Isra wal-Mi'raj. Mi'raj is a very long topic. Inshallah, today and next Friday, if it will remain something, inshallah, then after next Friday as well. Mi'raj and Isra. First of all, let me give you difference between Isra and Mi'raj. Isra, the journey of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam from Masjidul Haram to Jerusalem. From Masjidul Haram to Masjidul Aqsa. Call it Isra. And Mi'raj, from Jerusalem, from Masjidul Aqsa to the heavens, that we call it Mi'raj. Isra described in Quran. Is Allah Almighty says, "Min al Masjid al Haram ila al Masjid al Aqsa." And Mi'raj mentioned and described in a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. This blessed and significant journey narrated from more than 30 companions. And all of them narrated this blessed journey in different form. Something which is in Muslim, you will not find that in Bukhari. Something which is in Muslim and Bukhari, you will not find that part in other books of the Hadith. Because it narrated from more than 30 companions and all of them narrated in different form. So really it is very difficult for a person to put Mi'raj as one story and one incident. But inshallah I will try to bring all of these narrations together and make it a complete story, inshallah. But not today. Today only I am going to explain each letter of this particular verse in which story of Mi'raj described. Isra. Story of Isra described. No question arises and coming to the mind that Mi'raj is one story, one journey. And why it narrated and mentioned and described in different form? Brothers and sisters, actually Mi'raj is one story, Mi'raj is one journey. Isra and Mi'raj both took place in same night, but companions of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam heard this story from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And each companion, each human being not have a same memory. So they narrated the story of Mi'raj according to their mind and memory. How much they remembered, they narrated and conveyed it to the others. That's why Masjidul Aqsa, it is not described in Bukhari, but it is described in Muslim. Buraq, on which Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ride from Masjidul Haram to Masjidul Aqsa, Buraq is not described in Bukhari, but Buraq is described in other hadith. Similarly, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that when I was going from Masjidul Haram to Masjidul Aqsa, I passed through Musa's grave, through Musa al-Islam's grave, and I saw marartu bi qabri Musa fa idha hayyun yusalli fa idha huwa qa'imun yusalli aw kama qal. I passed Musa by Musa's grave and he was praying in his grave. It is not described in Bukhari, but it is described in other books of hadith. So, brothers and sisters, necessarily when you will open the book and literature, traveling literatures, you will find seven things concerning to a traveler. First of all, who make you to travel? For example, you have a business in America, in Canada, and you want to go to see your business. Business making you to travel from here to Canada. You have some relatives over there, and you want to go to visit them. Relatives making you to travel from here to Canada and to see them. So first of all is who make you to travel. Second, who travel? Male, female, who travel? Third and fourth, origin and end. From where to where you travel. Fifth, journey. This evening journey or morning journey? Where it took place? Morning time, evening time. Sixth, time of journey. In how much time journey took place? Short time, long time. Seventh, reason why journey took place. You will find these seven things in traveling literatures in the book of journeys. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described these seven things very clearly in His undoubtedly holy book, Quran al-Muqaddas. Because this was not traveling of an ordinary person, this was a traveling of entire best of creation, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when you have somebody as a companion in traveling, he could describe your traveling, what happened during the traveling, from where to place, why to place, all of this thing companion could describe. But Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has Jibreel and few angels, Jibreel and many angels, but not in entire journey. Jibreel was with him until the Sidratul Muntaha, that tree which is beyond seven heaven, you know. Until that tree, Jibreel was with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And after that, Jibreel says that, "Oh Muhammad, no, you have to go alone. If I will come with you from majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my wings will go to burn. Gar yaksar muwe partar param, faroghe tajalla basozat param." Farsi language. We speak each language, you know. Sheikh Saadi rahmatullahi ta'ala mentions in his Bostan, "Gar yaksar muwe batar param, faroghe tajalla basozat param." Jibreel told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in his tongue that, "O Prophet of Allah, if one wing I will put forward, then from majesty of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my wings will go to burn, so I cannot come across this limit. This is my last limit. No, you have to go and you have to speak and have conversation with your Lord." So no companion was with him in entire journey. How can companion describe properly journey? That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not choose any creation to mention this journey, but He Himself mentioned this journey in His holy book, Quran al-Muqaddas, by saying, "Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-aqsa." Who make you travel? First of all, He says, "Subhan," Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made Him to travel. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered all of those people who came after and raised so many issues and confusion about this journey.
it could be happen in very short time. Allah says, do not see traveler, see who make him to travel. Subhanalladhi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took him in very short space of time from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa. Why? لِنُرِيَهُ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا, to show him some of his signs. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if you're raising your finger on Mi'raj, this means you're raising your finger on power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In another word I could say, you're raising your finger on power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Second thing, who travel, Allah says, bi'abdihi, Allah took his beloved, his special servant. Why Allah says his servant, and why he did not say his prophet, his messenger? Why? He could say bin nabiyyihi. He could say subhanalladhi asra bi rasulihi. Subhanalladhi asra bi nabiyyihi. Subhanalladhi asra bi habibihi. Anyone he could use, but he used abd. Why? What is the secret? My dear respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us that look, this miracle is very unique miracle. It was not granted to anybody in past, and it will be not granted to anybody in future until the day of judgment. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is going to grant the highest miracle, but still he is a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is not part of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Still he is a slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So those who are under his status and rank, how can they be a part of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Understand? Respected brothers and sisters, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, from where to where journey took place first? He says, from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa. Then he says, Laylam. In how many time, in how much time journey took place? He says, Laylam. Mufassirin mentioned the Tanween, which is on Laylan. Tanween is for Taqleel, to mention the short space of time. Allah says, in very short space of time, during the night, this journey took place. And how short this time? Me and you cannot imagine that. It is not mentioned in any hadith, according to my study and mutala, clearly about that space of time. But one hadith narrated that Fuqida jasadun Nabi sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, at that night Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's body was not missed from his bed. So how short that time, that his body, narrated that, was not missed from the bed. Respected brothers and sisters, but then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choose from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa, he could choose any other mosque from Masjid al-Haram. Respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself mentioned that why he chose. He says, من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله. We choose from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa. Why? Because we have put blessing around that mosque, Masjid al-Aqsa. What are the blessings? Thousands of prophets came in children of Israel, in the nation of Israel, and all of them came in Masjid al-Aqsa. And most of them buried there as well. Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam, buried in Masjid al-Aqsa. Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, buried in Masjid al-Aqsa. Sayyidina Sulaiman alayhi salam, buried in Masjid al-Aqsa. Sayyidina Yaqub alayhi salam, buried in Masjid al-Aqsa. Sayyidina Dawud alayhi salam, buried in Masjid al-Aqsa. The kingdom, Sayyidina, I read somewhere that the pillar with which Prophet Sulaiman used to tie the jinn and punish them, that pillar still is there in Masjid al-Aqsa. which means Quran says and Allah says that the places where pious people are buried, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is placing, descending there always. So that's why it is not prohibited to visit the grave of pious people. If it would be prohibited, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not take His beloved servant from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa. Very clear. If it would be prohibited, remember, then Allah Almighty would not take His beloved from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa, because so many pious people are buried there in Masjid al-Aqsa. Respected brothers and sisters, this part of journey, there are three parts. One from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa, second from Masjid al-Aqsa to the heavens, and the third part from heaven to the above to the, and Allah subhanahu, He saw the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Prophet He spoke to Allah Almighty directly, you know, all of these three parts. So first part, ulama says, in Tafsirat Ahmadiyya, Hazrat Allama Mullah Ahmad Jeevan rahmatullahi ta'ala, he mentions that first part of the journey is recorded and narrated in Quran. So when a person will deny this part of journey, he will come out from this path. Because actually he is going to deny the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Second part is narrated in ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Ahadith in Bukhari, Muslim, many books. And the third part as well narrated in ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Prophet Musa alayhi salam requested to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, قَالَ رَبِّ أَرِنِي أَنْظُرُ إِلَيْكَ قَالَ لَنْ تَرَانِي. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, show me your exalted vision so may I can behold you. Allah says, لَنْ تَرَانِي. Never, you cannot see me. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put His majesty on mountain, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed Him with conversation, and Musa fell down, which is in Quran. But Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went beyond seven heavens, see Allah Almighty, spoke to Allah Almighty. So Musa was respected, Musa requested to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and beloved of Allah, invited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is different between Kalimullah and Habibullah. Someone who spoke to Allah Almighty and someone who is beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is different between Habibullah and Kalimullah. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Subhana alladhi asra bi'abdihi laylam minal masjidil harami ilal masjidil aqsa alladhi barakna hawlahu linuriyahu min ayatina. Why journey took place? He says, we took him from there to here to show him some of our signs. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw hell. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw paradise, jahannam, jannah, every single thing. Full surat. Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam had conversation with angels. Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam listened their conversation, heard their conversation, what they are speaking. Even in one hadith, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that in Mishkat, I was walking in paradise and I heard the voice of foot of Bilal. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, O Bilal, what virtues you have and what you doing? I heard the voice of your feet in paradise when I was walking in paradise. Subhanallah. Respected brothers and sisters, so this part, second part and third part, described in a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So ulama says that who will deny second part, he is a misled person, and who will deny third part of this mi'raj, actually his heart don't have a taste of iman and faith. And who will deny first part of the mi'raj, which is Isra, actually he will come out from the court of Islam, because he's going to deny Quran. أَفَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِبَعْضِ الْكِتَابِ وَتَكْفُرُونَ بِبَعْضِ. Now, Mi'raj took place from Masjid al-Haram. In some narration, we're going to find that Mi'raj took place from the house of Umme Hani. Umme Hani was aunt of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And in some narration, it narrated that Mi'raj took place from Kaaba. In some narration, it mentioned that when Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when Jibril came, Jibril took Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam from Masjid al-Haram to Kaaba first. And in Kaaba, the heart of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was taken out, and Jibril washed it from the water of Zamzam, and after that put it.